Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the Angular PDF Viewer component. Using this PDF viewer, you can load, view, and print the PDF file. You will get the best viewing experience with its interactive features such as zooming, text searching, bookmarks, table of contents, and more. In this video, I will show you the steps to create an Angular project using the Angular CLI tool. I will edit my code using Visual Studio Code and view the output result on Google Chrome, but any of the supported browsers will work. First, I need to install the Angular CLI on my machine using this command npm install -g at angular/cli. Since I have already installed Angular CLI in my machine, I am skipping this step. Now, let's proceed to create a new Angular project by typing the command ng new project name. I am going to create a project without the routing option, so let me give no and choose the CSS option to add a CSS style sheet. The project creation has started, and this will create an Angular project along with its dependencies. Once the installation is completed, I navigate to the newly created project folder. To start using the Syncfusion Angular PDF Viewer, I need to install the Syncfusion Angular PDF Viewer package by using this command npm install at syncfusion/ej2angularpdfviewer --save. This will install the package along with its dependencies. Alright, the Syncfusion Angular PDF Viewer package is installed, and now, my application is ready. The first thing I need to do here is to add the PDF Viewer component. Before that, I need to register the Syncfusion Angular trial license key, so open this main.ts file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Then, register the Angular trial license key using the register license method. From the 2022 Volume 1 release onwards, it is required to register the Syncfusion Angular license key. To see where to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Now, let's add the PDF Viewer component. First, open the app module file and import the PDF Viewer module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular PDF Viewer package. And register the same module within the imports array of the ng module section. Okay, next I am going to define the PDF Viewer component. In this app component HTML file, remove the default content and define the Angular PDF Viewer component using the EJS PDF Viewer tag. Then, add the style attribute to set custom height to 800 pixel and display property to block. Here, I am planning to show the default toolbar in the PDF viewer, so open app module file, import the toolbar service, and include the same in the providers section. Alright, now I will start to define CSS for the PDF viewer. So, open the style.css file and import the material theme. Here, I also added dependency CSS references like buttons, lists, pop-ups, navigations, and inputs. Now, save the changes and run the application by opening the terminal and typing the command ng-serve. This example is compiled successfully. So, let me move on to the output page. See the PDF Viewer component rendered with the default toolbar. By clicking this folder option in the toolbar, I can load a PDF file from the local path. You can notice the client-side error here. This is because the Angular PDF Viewer has a server-side dependency to load the PDF files. Not only for loading action, but also to perform other actions like zooming, navigation, making bookmarks, text searching, and more requires the server-side pre-processing of the PDF document. All these server-side actions need to be handled via a service project. In this video, I am not going to create a new service project now, but to handle all these server actions, I will refer to the existing service project that is hosted on a specific URL. This project is also available on GitHub, where you can see the direct methods available for loading a document, adding bookmarks, thumbnails, and so on. So now, I open the app component TS file and create a variable called hosted URL and assign the hosted service URL link. Then, move on to the app component HTML file and assign this hosted URL variable to the service URL property. Look here, the PDF file I selected is loaded in the PDF Viewer component. Suppose I want to load the PDF file programmatically, then I open the app component file and define a string variable, PDF path, and set appropriate PDF file name to it. This PDF file is available in the server-side hosted project. And now, I assign this variable to the document path property. So now, the PDF viewer initially loads the provided PDF document. Note here, the Angular PDF Viewer toolbar options are displayed, but they are in a disabled state. To enable the options in the toolbar, I need to inject the required services, so let's see the supported features one by one. First, I am going to enable the navigation option in the toolbar, so I simply import the navigation service from the Syncfusion Angular PDF Viewer package and include it in the providers section. See the PDF Viewer toolbar now, the navigation option is enabled. And you can navigate to the next page, previous, first, or last page of the PDF file. You can also navigate to specific pages by typing page numbers in the toolbar. Next, I am planning to show you the working of the bookmark feature. So, import the bookmark view service from the Syncfusion Angular PDF Viewer package and include it in the providers section. And now, the bookmark option is enabled in the toolbar. For example, I want to bookmark the first chapter. Then, click the bookmark option to select and bookmark the first chapter. Next, I will proceed to enable the page thumbnail option to display miniature representations of the pages in a PDF file. To do that, I import the thumbnail view service from this package and include it in the providers section. Look here, when I click the page thumbnail option, the PDF viewer displays small versions of the pages. While browsing this PDF file, you can see it contains a lot of URLs or website links. If I want to navigate to the URL pages, then I need to import the link annotation service from the Syncfusion Angular PDF Viewer package and inject the same in the providers section. When I click this link in the file, it navigates to the corresponding website. Notice here, the website opened in the current page. Suppose I want to open the website links in a new tab, then I can use the hyperlink open state property. To achieve that, I define a string variable and set its value to new tab. Then, assign this variable to the hyperlink open state property. See the PDF viewer, when I click this link, it opens in a new tab. Usually, a PDF file with more than a page or two will have a table of contents page. And if I want to navigate to a specific page from this table of contents page, I just need to click that particular topic to navigate. Alright, next I will show you how to enable these magnification tools in the toolbar. For that, I need to import the magnification service from the Syncfusion Angular PDF Viewer package and include the same in the providers section. Look here, you can zoom in and zoom out the page. For example, if I want to fit the page width within the available viewport size, then I can use the fit page option and use the fit width option to fit the viewport width based on the page content size. Now, if I want to reset the page content to the standard viewport size, then choose the automatic option from the pop-up. Okay, next let's proceed to see how to search text and select them in a PDF file. In this app module file, I import the text search service from the Syncfusion Angular PDF Viewer package and include it in the providers section. Also, I will add the text selection service and inject the same in the providers section. See the PDF Viewer component, the search tool is enabled in the toolbar, and it can be used to find the required text content in a file. Next, I am going to select the text, so choose the text select tool and select the content in the PDF file. Apart from these options, you can also see two more options enabled in the toolbar. Click this download option to save the PDF file. And when you click this print option, it is not possible to print the file because you need to add the print service. So, import the print service from the Syncfusion Angular PDF Viewer package and include it in the providers section. Now, if I click the print option, the PDF file will be printed. Look here, the default toolbar options are shown, but if you want to customize the options, you can use toolbar items property. So, I define an object, custom toolbar, and assign the options you want inside the toolbar items property. Also, I set the show tooltip property to true to enable tooltip for the toolbar items. Then, I assign this variable to the toolbar settings property. Now, the PDF Viewer toolbar is displayed with custom options like download, print, and search. By default, the toolbar is visible in the PDF Viewer. Suppose I want to hide the toolbar, then define the enable toolbar property and set its value to false. See now, the toolbar is hidden in the component. Similarly, you can also hide the navigation toolbar. For that, I simply need to define the enable navigation toolbar property and set its value to false. Look here, the navigation toolbar is hidden. Alright, next I will show how to load and unload PDF files dynamically using the button component. Here, I am going to use the Syncfusion Angular Buttons component, so I install that package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2angularbuttons --save. It takes a few seconds to complete the package installation, so let's wait. As you can see, the package is installed. Okay, now let's proceed to define the button component. First, I open the app module file and import the button module from the Syncfusion Angular button package and register the same module inside the imports array. Then, navigate to the app component HTML file and define the button component with the content load. As I said earlier, I am going to load PDF files dynamically using a button click, so add the click event with the event handler load document. Then, move on to the app component TS file and define the event handler here. Inside this method, I am going to make a call to the built-in method of PDF viewer named load. To access this built-in method here, I need to create an instance for the PDF viewer component first. So, open the app component HTML file and add a reference variable PDF viewer. Then, I go back to the app component TS file and add a view child directive and pass that reference variable PDF viewer. Next, I define a variable named PDF object of type PDF viewer component. You can see here the view child directive and the PDF viewer component class are imported automatically from the appropriate packages. Now, inside the load document method, I make a call to the load method by using the PDF viewer instance. To this load method, I can pass two types of inputs, base64 string and file name. As I am going to use base64 string, so pass the base64 string as the first argument, an empty string as the second, because there is no password for the specified PDF. Now, I am planning to load the PDF dynamically, so let me remove the document path property from the code. When you click this button, the PDF file is loaded. Next, I will load the PDF using the file name. Within this event handler, let me replace the base64 string with this PDF file name. See now, the PDF viewer loads this PDF file. Finally, I will show you how to unload a PDF file dynamically. To do this, first, I define one more button component with content, unload. Then, add a click event with the event handler, unload document. And, I define this event handler here. Inside this unload document, call the unload method by using the PDF viewer instance. Look here, when you click the unload button, it unloads the PDF file from this PDF viewer component. In this video, I have shown you how to create an Angular project using Visual Studio Code and how to add the Syncfusion Angular PDF Viewer component to it. You also saw how to load, view, print, and download PDF files. I have also shown you how to enable and use the navigation and magnification tools in the toolbar. Finally, you saw how to load and unload the PDF document dynamically. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire Angular suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.